what you expected at this time in the morning. I have no idea what time it is anymore.
It's 5 o'clock and it's not quite what I expected. I expected it to be a little closer than it proved to be. And I'm very pleased to see that it isn't. So it's not quite what I expected, but it is the time I expected it, 5 o'clock.
And of course, Edinburgh is still to come in, and that's widely expected to be a no vote.
We think Edinburgh will be a no vote because it nearly always has been, and it depends on the percentage. But even if it's a big percentage, or even if it's a small percentage, I think the no votes would have won.
You're happy with this?
Of course I'm happy with that. Very happy with that. Very much so indeed. Thank you.
So far, it's gone the way our polling suggested.
And we have put in across Edinburgh and across Scotland shows that people want the answers to the questions we were asking about the economy, about their pensions, about their investments, and none of these answers were forthcoming.
Hereby certify and declare the total number of ballot papers counted in the referendum in the City of Edinburgh Council area is 319,025. For yes, 123,927 votes. No, 194,000.
Well, first and foremost, I'm absolutely delighted with the level of voter engagement and turnout here in Edinburgh. We're just short of 85% of the population who registered to vote have cast their preference in yesterday's referendum. I think that's fantastic news. I really, really do appreciate everybody's engagement in the process, and I completely respect everybody who's voted yes, but there's a very clear result here in Edinburgh overnight tonight, 60-40% in favour of Scotland remaining in the United Kingdom.
And, you don't think it would have been a good thing for Edinburgh to have had more government here, perhaps more people coming to live in?
We've got a devolved parliament here with very, very substantial powers, and there's been a very, very clear message from the population of Edinburgh tonight and this morning that they believe that devolved parliament is the best way forward. Of course it needs additional powers, and the No side are committed to delivering on those additional powers, and I would urge the SNP in particular to engage with that process now in delivering those extra powers for the Scottish Parliament, the devolved parliament that's going to remain within the United Kingdom.